So Francesco has to go. We have his email, so if you need to ask more questions to him, you're welcome to address him by email. Thank you very much. So we've been, let's have an applause. So we've been already discussing uncertainties, and we are going to continue because this is an important issue. So we understand that pool is better than local estimates. You can consider all existing studies. You can do weighting averages and adjust your estimates and have better uncertainty than just using one single study. So Andrea Renzi is back from yesterday. So he's from ARPA. He's going to speak again about uncertainties. You switched? Okay. So we're going to change the. We're going to slightly change the program, shifting the two presentations by Andrea. So we are starting with the environmental burden disease and integrated HIA, and we'll then come back to the uncertainties with the case study, I guess. So we also have at the end of the morning, we'll have a general discussion at the end of the morning. So if you have some feedback or want to ask specific questions about your cases, you'll be welcome to do that. Okay, we'll also review the questionnaires. So if you have not yet answered the questionnaire that we presented yesterday, please do that. The idea is to check what type of data you can access, what you're missing, and maybe have some help or some recommendations.
Okay. Okay. Good morning again. I switched the two presentations because I think that. Because the idea is to talk more about.
Is it okay?
I try. The idea is to make a sort of direct calculation of attributable cases and impact assessment with some examples and some direct exercise with you. And so I've prepared just now some. Calculation, and I prefer to start with this presentation and talking about uncertainty in the second part if we have more time to talk about. Many of the argument of the background of my presentation has already presented by Francesco, by Massimo, and others. So I will go quickly in this part. But with all the information we retrieve in these days, we are almost ready to perform some calculation of health impact assessment of air pollution. We in this morning, in the lesson before, Francesco talked about concentration response, exposure response function, or concentration response function, as you want to name. Yesterday we talked about exposure data and how to assess exposure to the population involved in our studies. Massimo talk about background disease in terms of mortality or other outcomes and mortality rates or other outcomes. So it's time now to make a calculation. The calculation is related to variety of health effects, starting from mortality, but also morbidity and other under health outcomes. In the final exercise, we will see that different kind of health outcomes can be considered in an health impact assessment, not only mortality. So there is a question, there is a problem in how to express together impact on mortality and morbidity in a unique way, with a unique number, without talking about number of deaths and plus and the number of hospital admission or other or number of this annoyance from some exposure, and so there is. I will briefly introduce, and I think that at the end of the morning or in the afternoon, other lectures go through this aspect with the concept of DALIS and concept of measure that can bring together the information about mortality and morbidity. This, I split some slides because the definition of HIA has been already more than once explained. I want to stop now in a minute on the last publication from Lancet Commission on Pollution and Health that made a burden of disease of pollution in general, and so not only air pollution, but water, soil, and exposure due to water and soil is more and or other than air pollution, and they write a very very powerful, very good report on the Lancet journal, with a robust call to arms. And then the argumentation are very, very strong, but brimming with optimism because they have information, they have a suggestion about immediate action to reduce these exposures. They calculate 6.5 million of deaths per year due to household air pollution, ambient and household air pollution, so outdoor and indoor. And they compare it with the deaths for tobacco smoke, and they assess that they are most more or less similar. And they said that this number will increase if urgent measures are not taken. So this is a very strong sentence. And the reason for this final sentence that this number will increase is related not only to measure that has been taken by the stakeholders, but also from the augmented knowledge about health effects of air pollution. And they provide in the article this scheme that suggests us that the estimation of 9 million for overall pollution is related to what we effectively know, and we know in terms not only of existence of health effects, but also quantification of the dose response, the concentration response, exposure response function. So only in this case we can do calculation and we can assess the health impact. But there is a second zone about emerging health effects of known pollutants. We know that other pollutants, emerging pollutants, new exposures are harmful to health, but we have not yet knowledge about the and evidence to suggest a concrete, a robust concentration response function. And so this is an area under study that is not yet included in the overall estimation. So another reason for the potential increase in the next years. And a final zone, the zone three, that regard emerging pollutants for which we have not yet adequately characterized health effects. So this is another possible answer to the question we have to study again, or we can stop studying health effects of air pollution and move only to action. No, we have to do both because we have already have to know the effect. This is a simplified version of the scheme that Francesco showed yesterday about the WHO, with the big discussion about possible error in the left part. There is not a left part, so we are safe about possible error. But this is the impact pathway. And again, we have already talked about policy, about emissions, about concentration, and starting with this about exposure yesterday. We have talked about background disease rates. This morning, we have talked about health effects, and now we have to talk about impact. I think that Kaga has already talked about this definition, so I put in my slide, but I don't comment. You have several links to go into this definition. And the calculation, the quantitative estimation of the impact assessment is related to the central part of this slide, so the part of the execution in which we select a reference scenario, a baseline scenario, and we compare it with an alternative scenario, the counterfactual scenario that Francesco and others said yesterday. So the calculation is related to two different situations that can be in two different ways, exposure versus not exposed, exposed people and versus not exposed people, because we can assess the health impact of exposed people to an environmental stress. So in the exercise, we will do that. We will do this situation. We have started the exercise yesterday with the exposure assessment to landfill in Europe. We will go on through this exercise. In this exercise, in this situation, this case study, there is exposed people versus not exposed people without any information about quantification of exposure. We selected, we define as exposed people living near the environmental stressor such as a landfill. The other possibility is to have a quantification of exposed people. So the exposure response function that Francesco showed before are related to increase in concentration of PM2.5 or other pollutants. So in this case, we have a counterfactual scenario that is different from the baseline scenario in terms of concentration of pollutants to which all people is exposed. So we have not exposed versus not exposed, but all people is exposed to different level of pollutants. This is important to consider this two possibility in the calculation, in the formula that we will analyze now. Also, this part has been already discussed about the formula of attributable fraction that is mainly you have to to sign this part of the formula, as Francisco said, the relative risk minus one divided by the relative risk, that is the attributable fraction to for exposed people, because in any situation we will assess impact for exposed people. So the formula, I think that the formula in the simplest way, the formula is in the first version is related to people exposed without information about the quantification of exposure. So in the case of landfill, in which we have the attributable fraction for exposed people, the background population incidence rate that you can retrieve from Health for All database or other information, local information if you have, and who is and how many people is exposed. So population, exposed people. This is the very simple, at the end of the big discussion we have made, we have a very simple equation to calculate attributable case. In the case of counterfactual scenario based on different level of exposure, we add to this formula, sorry, B0 is the same of rate pop gen, of course. We add the differential in concentration that is often almost ever divided by 10 because evidence of concentration response function are provided for increase of 10 microgram per cubic meter. So it's a common way to write the attribute cases for environmental for air pollution in this way, but the reason is related to the concentration response function. So this is the very simple formula, and now we try to calculate some in different way these attributable cases for different situation. This is again an explanation that provide information from that derive from the population attributable fraction as Francesco explained yesterday, in which if you consider that the population exposed is all population. If we put one to this function and not a fraction, you can go back to this formula. So in this morning, I will try, and I hope that I've not made some calculation error. In principle, I was a mathematician, so it would be very sad for me, but we have to check. I try to make a very simple calculation without any data for myself, because a lot of questions in these days was related to what can I do if I have not information, if I have not data, if I have not possibility to have a big big data, big information, big possibility to monitoring air pollution. So Francesco mentioned this website is a very, very, very good website, also very interesting also in the graphic way, that is breathlife 2030.org, that is a WHO website in which you can put here the name of the city you are interested on, and the website provide a level, a mean level, annual level for PM2.5. Another website, very, very, very useful, very rich of information, is the website of Health for All. Massimo yesterday presented this website. I had another internet address. Going through the website, I have arrived to this web page, in which is always health for all, in which there is a very big possibility, very huge possibility of retrieving information about demographic and health data. So with these two web pages, we can, in a very rough way, calculate data we need for a rough estimation of impact assessment due to air pollution. I've tried to do for Trieste, so we are in now Trieste. Yes. I see that Trieste is, in these 2 days, I have the perception that Trieste is a good state to live. And this website confirmed that it's a good also from the, not only from the sightseeing or the sea, but also from air pollution level, because 15 as a mean level of PM2.5 in northern Italy is a good level. I live in Modena in the famous Po Valley, and I this is a dream for me. This not in the opposite, but in the red part for sure. So if you wrote Trieste, you write Trieste in the web page of Breastlife. The website provides this information that is 15 micrograms per cubic meter as a mean yearly level of air pollution, of PM2.5 in the city of Trieste. And the website alerts you that you are happy, but you are 50% over the safe level of the WHO indication, that is 10. So this is the situation. In the other website, I calculate the mortality. I don't have time to go to the website. I found quickly the crude mortality rate in Italy, that is 10.3 for every 1,000 population. For 2012, with more time, you can look at more precise data. But with these two information and a quick survey on Wikipedia to retrieve population of Trieste, I have tried to calculate the attributable cases for the PM2.5 in Trieste. The problem is that the number is here. Okay, it's, yeah, but it's 69.
We just need to see that, which is behind that. Can we?
Yes.
Yeah, at the top of it.
10.3 is the crude mortality rate in Italy.
Yeah, it's okay.
So. Thank you. The background incidence rate for the health outcomes we have considered, that is total mortality, natural mortality. And 1.07 is the last published WHO estimate for natural mortality. Francesco said that now is 10. Yeah. Long-term effect. Yes, absolutely long-term effect of natural.
Because it's very important, because we are driven by the data that we have. As we have a mean annual average of the pollutants, we shall take into account just long-term mortality. That's why this blocked, I mean, we cannot do anything else.
Yes, with further rough assumption, we can derive also short-term, but it's another jump.
If I may ask about the 10 milligram per meter cube, this is the...
No, microgram. I have made an error.
Okay.
It's microgram. Yes. You find my error. Okay. You find the first. You find the first error. obviously, it's microgram. Microgram. Yes. Yes. Okay. The concentration response function, the 7% of increase is the suggestion of WHO for natural mortality and an increase of 10 micrograms for cubic meter of PM2.5. So we can calculate the burden of disease, the attributable cases, the health impact assessment due to the excess of in Trieste of air pollution in respect of the WHO indication. So this delta C, that the delta is a concentration, is 15, that the mean annual value, minus 10, that is the maximum level that WHO suggests. So if you, I hope that if you put this... No, I don't understand.
No, because you point at the 10 microgram by cubic meter to say 10. It's not that 10. In the formula, we want to calculate the delta, which is in this case, because we are choosing that, we can choose another counterfactual. 10 is what the WHO says. No, because when you said 10, you point the increase in the pollutant.
Okay.
No, because this is very important.
This 10 is the level suggested by WHO.
Please don't leave this room if you don't understand this simple calculation, because it's so easy that we want to be sure that everything is clear.
Yes, it's very simple, but behind this calculation there is a huge work. But the calculation is very, very, very simple, yes. This is the mean annual value of pollutant of PM2.5 in Trieste. This 10 is the suggested value by WHO as a limit, as an upper limit for PM2.5. This 10 is the division of this value, because the WHO provide estimation for an increase of 10 microgram for cubic meter of PM2.5. Is clear? Okay. So, attributable fraction, relative risk minus 1 divided by the relative risk, background incidence rate, population multiplied by the crude rate of mortality in Trieste. In Italy, we applied another assumption, obviously. We applied the crude rate mortality, the Italian crude rate mortality, to the city of Trieste. This already explained, population exposed is a fraction. So one is an indication of total population. We are all exposed to PM2.5. All inhabitants in Trieste are exposed to PM2.5 due to Trieste. So this calculation provides the 69 that, if you can see the last line, is the 3.5% of total mortality. So with this very rough estimation, we can say that in Trieste, 3.5% of total mortality is due to an excess of air pollution related to the WHO limit. That is a good news for Trieste, because the mean value in Italy is range about 6-7%. So is a confirmation that Trieste is a good city to live. Number of cases of mortality that are attributable to the excess of 5 microgram per cubic meter of mean level of PM2.5 in Trieste. The comparison, if we go back,
What happens if the PM2.5? What happens if the PM2.5 concentrations are less than 10 micrograms per cubic meter?
It's a good question. We change the contact factor scenario. I will change the contact factor scenario. No, you mean that the result is negative?
Yeah.
Okay. Below 10. Yeah. If you made this calculation, you will find a negative result. But in terms of interpretation of this
two aspects. One is that we are trusting WHO that says no effect below 10. Because in Italy we have natural sources of PM, so what we can do for that, nothing. So now we know from the American studies that Francesco shows, the one of the last slides of Francesco, that there is also an effect below 10, so we have to WHO is updating the recommendations, because we cannot ignore that now some studies show an effect even below the 10 microgram, but it could be meter. Sometimes when you do any other assumption and you use different levels as threshold, you can find minus number of death. In that case, in your report for the localities, for everybody, you simply put a zero, which means that no cases are attributable at that level of exposure. So when the results are minus, it's safe for the population. Leave it there, there's no problem, but don't report. I will talk on the last day of how to create a report. Please put on zero, because otherwise there will be, how does it mean, minus number of deaths.
What I am trying to understand, if if we consider the range between 0 and 10 microgram per square meter, so we are, I am asking, if we are in the baseline of the mortality, and if we exceed 10 micrograms, so in this case we estimated the number of deaths of diseases related to the sexes, that's right or not?
For yes. Each 10 microgram increase, you will have 7%, now we know that it's 10, but let's say 7% increase of disease. This is, Andrea is now, this morning when Francesco was speaking, I said, okay, let me try if I can find this quick solution for people that doesn't have anything, because the database is worldwide, so you can put the name of the main cities all over the world, and also level of pollution are available. But now in the Excel files with the real calculation, we can find several other aspects that just I'm saying you, let's wait for the next part of the lessons of Andrea.
I want to comment also after you, if you want. No, it's okay. So one important thing, because we didn't insist enough, there is no thresholds for air pollution. Probably we thought that everyone was knowing that. Just the first day showed that this is so true that there are two works from Canada, Barnett, showing that for 4 microgram per cubic meter, .3, you get effect. And actually, in many cases, if you want, I can provide you all these studies for morbidity, mortality, etc., showing that for some people, because this is individual susceptibility, some people react very soon to air pollution. So they have in general, they are susceptible, vulnerable, etc. Another thing is really very important is the one here, because it's true, air pollution is ubiquitous. All the population is exposed, and in epidemiology, very often, overall in indoor studies, but we are not doing that, to fix in some way a cut for saying exposed and not exposed, so that so that we can apply statistical methods, having a model, etc. But this is the strong point of this approach, because you say that all the population is exposed, and for me, really, this is an asset. So we go there.
A simple note, I checked the website for Trieste, it's 15% over the safe level, and this gives 21,000 deaths, and I checked for Cairo, my city, and it's 7.6 times the safe level, and gives almost the double of this.
7.6 times, so...
Yes. Higher than the safe level by 7 times.
So 76?
No, 7.6.
Times
the safe level.
For the level of WHO?
The safe level, yes. Uh-huh.
Yes, the level of WHO is 10, so I think...
So it gives the double of the deaths. Yes. This is 15% of the safe level in Cairo, 7.6.
Okay, you can try to calculate. No, okay. No, you can try to calculate for your city in this way. Yes,
I'm just asking if you checked 15 there is the annual mean average level of PM. So 15 is not 15% up or low.
What's the number here for your city?
Instead of 15 for El Cairo.
The question that how high levels of pollution in Cairo and the low deaths from Morocco.
We
see that low levels of pollution in Rome than in Cairo, and the higher number of deaths of mortality in Rome less than Egypt.
For 50% over than the limit, the safe limit, gives 21,000 deaths for in Trieste.
For these
numbers gives 20,000 deaths. 21,000 deaths.
21.
Yes. It's from the website.
Okay. The difference could be related on a more update concentration response function or order. I don't know what the concentration response function used by the breath life for the calculation and the population of Trieste. Of course, this is a rough estimate, but if you use 1.5 or 1.6, that is the old suggestion of WHO, you have a lower number, and also population in Trieste by the breast life, I don't know if the river. Okay, the other possibility is mortality, yes. It's possible that the rate of mortality in Trieste is lower than in the whole Italy.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Another.
I've just got a question from Samane. She's asking how 69, the AT of Trieste, changed to 3.5% of mortality. Yes.
3.5 is related to the total mortality. So the 2,100 is total mortality. 69 is 3.5% of the total mortality in Trieste.
It was done very quickly, and maybe we should have put in the slide also the number of total deaths. So to prove that the results is 3.5. Yes, it's there, but not related.
With this, as Kaga said correctly, with this crude mortality rate, this is a crude mortality rate for overall mortality, not natural mortality. So this probably is an overestimation of the real number. We, I put this rough in the initial because it could be improved, it could be with more sensitive data. With this crude rate mortality applied to the population, the mortality, the annual mortality in Trieste is this one.
Can you tell the difference between general mortality and natural mortality? Because otherwise we are not understand each other. I'll tell you. General mortality is total number of death, independent of the cause. Just people die and you count one, zero if you are alive. The natural mortality, and we have to take into account that because all the response functions are estimated for natural mortality, are total number of deaths excluding accidents. So the accidents, because there is no any plausibility to relate accident incidents, I mean traffic accidents, incidents at home. So that's no okay, but it's, so it's
also
less
violent,
violent cause, suicide, homicide. They are not included in this calculation. Yeah. So far, yes, I say, just because we have to realign on function that say that, so we can exclude that. Huh? Can I?
Okay, my
sorry, the question was crimes should be considered or not? No. I mean, natural mortality is not considering crimes, of course. A bullet is not particles, is airborne things, but it's not particles. I mean, so crimes, other violent kind of death are not considered in natural death. So the crude mortality here consider also people that were shot for any cause, but the natural mortality should not must not consider this kind of things. Yes, are excluded.
Okay. Mine is a minor one. I may have missed it, but in the second term, I see a product of population and crude mortality rates.
Yeah.
And the crude mortality rate I see is 10.3 per 1,000 people. Will that not translate to 0.0103?
In this slide is for 1,000 people.
So that should give you a 0.01.
Yes. In fact, yes, absolutely. Yeah, another error, but the result is correct. I forgot to write a zero here. Yes. That's okay. the total error are 5. You have to, okay. The result is correct. Okay. This is a good information that they you have understood the formula.
We've okay. Got the last question.
Yes.
I have a question. In most of the developing countries, the mortality percentage is given nationally. That is a national percentage. And in most of the countries, the percentage is given and considering sometimes all the kind of deaths. How it is possible to dissociate?
It's related to the variability of information about exposure response function. If you have information about a single outcome, a single health outcome, you can, and also background incidence of this single health outcome, you can do that. Yeah, we will see in the exercise this.
Okay, just to say that so far, for PM, for example, you have available information about natural mortality, lung cancer, some cardiovascular disease and respiratory disease. That's it. If you don't have the possibility to have a cause-specific mortality, you just have general mortality. You cannot have natural mortality. Provide the calculation anyway and put sign a note saying, because I don't, because our national, in our national, the data are not available for natural mortality, we used general mortality instead of natural mortality. You could, but it's another assumption, evaluate if in other countries in Africa or related, is this data is available, calculate the percentage in that other country, apply at your own population. It's simply possible to say that the very important thing is to be really clear in your report.
Okay.
So other people reading you can judge, say, okay, okay, I understand that is probably overestimation of the death because you are not excluding incidents by trauma, homicide, suicide, violent causes. But you can still do that. It's not garbage. I mean, it's science. But you have to explain exactly your assumptions and the uncertainties.
Okay.
Yes, you have always to explain uncertainty.
Yes.
On every point you are, because a perfectionist.
That's very far.
Before the break, a couple of minutes to conclude this aspect, and during the break I will correct the slide, so you... WHO have thing to us make... A powerful tool that is based on mainly on the, on this kind of formula, but provide a software tool for this risk assessment of air pollution that is AirQ. In the last version is AirQ Plus has been completed in the last year the version of AirQ Plus, and now I know that WHO. Organize also courses and updates for who wants to learn the functionality of the software. It is a very user-friendly software in which you have to put information like the information we have seen before about pollution, about demography, about health outcome, and. You can use for cities, for countries, for region to estimate the burden of disease due to air pollution. And you can define the scenario, you can define the area you want to analyze, and so on. And this is a very quick information about this, but you are invited to download it. It is a free software to download it, to try. I have used the old version. I have not already seen the new version, but it was very, very, very easy to use for information are already stored in the software about concentration response function, about demography, and I think some information also about pollution, but I don't remember where. But you have to put your data, and the software provide calculation for different population, different concentration response function, and all this information is are writable and changeable. Also there is also a wonderful manual that with many examples that you can go on to through the selector to understand how to use. I think that is now for coffee break in 10 minutes? No.
10 minutes would be fantastic. If you could be back in 10 minutes, would be fantastic. Coffee's over there waiting for you.
C'est juste...